This is your trigger. This is the butt of the weapon. This is the magazine. Well, where you're going to feed the magazine in.
So I'm always going to treat every gun, right? Every single gun as if it's loaded, right?
We are an African-American organization who's rooted in pride of being African-Americans, and we're very proud of our culture. We're very proud of our heritage. So that's why we chose the colors black, red, and green.
Keep your finger off the trigger.
So me and Mike happen to be very good friends, and we were having some discussions about firearm safety and kind of the rise of African-American firearm sales throughout the country and how more people were buying firearms. And so we said that, you know, who's training these folks? Who's educating these folks? We sort of just came up with the idea over the phone, just kind of talking it up, and said, hey, why don't we start an organization that may be able to give some of those resources?
Well, it goes, sits up here. When this slide goes forward, the action closes. So once there's a round in the chamber, that's when you can actually pull the trigger to make a round go down range. And it's black, safety's on.
What we've seen is African-American firearm sales are up around 60% in the past year or two. I think part of that is due to a couple different factors. The first factor would be that people just don't feel safe. With the pandemic, with some of the social unrest that's been going on, people just don't feel safe. And so not only are African-American firearm sales up, firearm sales across the board are up. What we're here for and what's important to us is that we are here to educate that underserved population that typically has not historically had those resources available to them. And typically what has been the image depicted of African Americans with guns has usually been a very negative image. And so what's important to us is to sort of change that image into something positive. It's just important to us that we push the firearm safety piece, we push the awareness piece, and we push the training piece, because when you got 60% of an increase in firearm sales in this particular community, it's important that these people know how to be safe with the firearms, and it's also important that they know how to use the firearms, should they ever have to.
Me being in a single parent home, I have a child in my home, and I want to be able to protect her. I don't want to have to wait for someone else to come and advocate for me or be able to protect my home. I need to be able to do that myself.
If firearm sales amongst the black community began to fall, I think the need is still there nonetheless. I think the need has always been there. And that this spike just kind of sparked the conversation.
I wasn't raised in a home that was firearm savvy. So there was a lot of fear surrounding firearms and guns, and for a very long time. And then I got connected with Rochester African American Firearms Association, and that education portion opened my mind to what firearms are for. So without that education, I probably wouldn't want to have a gun, or still would be in that mindset of fear.
Education is universal. We can all learn from each other, and we do. I just think people of color would like to see other people of color as instructors or as educators, and they may be more willing and open to listen to what they have to say, especially if they don't have an initial interest, right? To somebody that looks like them or somebody that can relate to them. Yes. Are there organizations that exist on a national level that may not have particularly made it a priority for them to educate the African American community or embrace the African American community? Sure. But I think at this point, we're something that can't be ignored.